The concept of drawing is incredibly simple, but the execution is very complex. If the idea of an accurate drawing is to put the lines and shapes in the right place, using a simple mark-making tool like a pencil, why is that so hard for us to do this? Nearly everyone can tell when a drawing or painting of a face is inaccurate, but if you ask them then to correct it, chances are that they can't. A big part of this problem we face in drawing is a lack of connection from our mind to our hand. One way to get around this is to start as simply as we can. I'm going to introduce you to a term called block-in. In visual arts, a block-in refers to a simplified yet accurate drawing. It's basically a map without any features. A good block-in is going to tell me exactly where major landmarks are, but not the smaller and more specific details. We do this for a few reasons. Firstly, it allows us to place our subject on the page in a way that fits nicely. We can play around with different compositions and arrangements very quickly when we stay loose like this. We're not too invested. More importantly, blocking in allows us to map out basic proportions of our subject. This is extremely useful because we don't want to be working for hours on a drawing and focusing on details like eyes when they're in the wrong place. We'll just have to end up erasing them in the end, and that can be frustrating. So what's a good amount of time to spend on a block in? I always say that the amount of time you should spend on it is just as long as it takes. You'll find that, like most things, if the foundation of your drawing is good, everything you build on top of it will be much, much stronger. Let's take a look at how we begin a block-in. I'm going to start with these references of facial features, eyes in this case. These are a great way to start because they don't throw too much information at us at once, like an entire face. I'll start with the eye here, this one. Now, at first glance, this feature is quite complex. There are a number of angles and complicated intersecting shapes, but for now I'm going to ignore almost all of that information and think of this as more of a silhouette. And how would I simplify this? I'm going to break this down as simply as I can with as few angles and lines as possible while capturing the character of the shape. First, I'll mark where I intend the drawing to sit on the page so I don't end up going off the page or place it in an awkward way. So I'm going to make a mark here and here. And this is useful because I know everything that I draw is going to take place in between these two lines. I may shift things around a bit as I go, but in general, it's good practice to try to stay within the dimensions you set at this stage. Now, this is very important, and you'll hear me repeat this often. I'm only using straight lines to describe this shape while blocking in. Block-ins should not contain any curved lines. I'm also not concerned with tone, or what we call value, at this stage. That's for much later on. This is more difficult than it may seem, and you'll find that at the beginning of your drawing, much of your time will be spent at this stage trying to get the shapes to fit together correctly. So again, I'm only using straight lines to describe this, and I know that this is a curved shape, but I want to break it down as simply as I can into angles. I'm looking for points that I would call an angle break. Okay, so I see this shape comes up here, and then it changes direction about here. And you can follow along in the reference. It goes up here, it changes direction, and then it changes direction again here. So I'm doing these same marks here, here, and here. I'm just concerned with this simple shape, and I'm not going to get it right at first, and that's okay. I'm paying attention to the distance between here and here, and I'm just trying to get this general shape in as few lines as possible. Now, one thing I notice is that the eyebrow goes to this side of the eye. So I know that if I end the eyebrow here, it's too short. We're going to start using just checks for ourselves like that as we work to keep our drawings accurate. Even this iris of the eye, even though it's a circle for the most part, I'm going to break it down into straight lines. And again, the reason we do this is to provide structure to the work. Because as we work on it, we inevitably break down that structure. So the more structure we have in the beginning, the more we can retain for later in the drawing. Now I'm getting close to capturing a general shape. I could call it a blocking at this stage, but it doesn't have quite the amount of information that I'm looking for. I want to know how these specific internal shapes exist and interact as well. But at this stage, we're just using our intuitions to try and understand this image and replicate it. We'll learn more advanced tools later on. It's like playing scales in music. We have to get these basics down before we move forward for more melodies or advanced concepts. And the more we train this connection between our mind and our hand, the better we are able to describe the things the way we see them. We're going to bring these block-ins to about this level. This basic drawing has all of the structural information that I need to move forward with a strong drawing. I want to pay attention to shapes and make sure that they're properly proportioned before I move forward. Now, it doesn't tell me anything about the dark or light parts, and that's okay. We're not concerned with that at this point. Remember, we're focused on building a foundation, not details. If we do this correctly, it will act like a scaffold and lend its structure to all the other stages of our drawing. There's no pressure at this stage. If you find yourself getting frustrated because you can't capture the shape, don't worry, you're not alone. Just take a moment and step away, take a few breaths, and try again. Every time we attempt this, we get better, and we are improving that connection between our mind and our hand.